sausages, Barcelona, and long-distance commutes. And these things may seem very, very strange now, but all will become apparent, and by the end of this presentation, I hope you'll have a newfound trust in the next generation of housing leaders. The private rented sector is the main destination for young people, and the reason I say this is that 40% of under 35s currently rent privately, double the amount who rent socially. Hot off the press, recent research carried out by members of Generation Y highlights the negative perception that young people have of social housing. What makes us so sure that when our older customers vacate their general needs accommodation, we will have young people to fill the gap? We could not be complacent. In the housing world, we have a polarisation between the housing haves and the housing have-nots. So there is a clear moral imperative for us to deal with this issue. The generation rent has highlighted many of the precarious situations that private renters face. The moral imperative for the sector to do something about this is clear, to offer a real choice for young people in a disjointed housing market that is so lopsided that one young man finds it cheaper to live in Barcelona and commute to London than live on these very shores. And what of Barcelona? The regeneration of Barcelona went hand in hand with affordable housing. Young people able to afford to live in the metropolis with money left over to spend in a thriving local economy. Sounds good, doesn't it? But how do we start to deliver for Generation Y? How do we start to deliver the housing that the young people of today need? We have to acknowledge as social housing providers that as it stands, we are failing to compete with the private rented sector. Now this may sound like a commercial analysis, but it is ironic that it is our social edge that will give us our competitive edge. There is an old marketing phrase, don't sell the sausage, sell the sizzle. Basically, the emotions attached to a product are important, and this applies even more so in the digital age. It is essential that as well as getting the product right for young people, that we have an ongoing conversation, much in the same way that we have with our communities for years, but in a dialogue that is fit for the 21st century, so we can link the intrinsic values that young people hold with their housing choice, namely the ethical choice to rent from a social housing provider, with the value, fairness, security, and decent quality homes that young people need. But what about the product? The government's retreat from subsidising housing is all the same, and so as a result, we must look to other interested parties in order to make development viable. We cannot go it alone. So who has the capital, who has the land, and who has the housing experience? The devolution agenda gives us a real opportunity to identify key stakeholders and businesses in our areas who have a vested interest in delivering housing for young people in our areas. This is not just a case of looking for a corporate responsibility SOC. Financially, housing as an asset is unlikely to depreciate, and businesses will feel a lot of comfort coming together with organisations with a wealth of housing experience to offer rental and home ownership solutions to their workforce. A practical vision of how housing as an economic function as well as an economic driver can lead us to a high wage, high employment economy. And it is apt, as we are in close proximity to Bourneville Village, that it is businesses coming together with social landlords who will be the main vehicle for pumping up the volume. But in the 21st century, nothing occurs in isolation. Can you imagine a world where 1.5 billion people live in slums? That is the current prediction. The need for affordable housing is clear, for society, for decency, for humanity. What is needed is something akin to the WHO, not World Health Organization, but a World Housing Organization, set up to coordinate global solutions to this very global issue. With the nation state seemingly in retreat, it will be housing providers and not governments who will form the basis of this organisation. The onus is on us now to start forging international links so that in the future, an image of this will contain housing providers with a strong brand identity collaborating together with a common goal in mind. But who will make all these things happen? By 2020, 40% of current housing professionals will have retired. By this point, 50% of the global workforce will be part of Generation Y. The challenge to the sector is to engage these young people and their values with clear talent management planning in order to recruit great leaders for the challenges ahead. Because it is these leaders who will lead us into an ever-changing political climate. It is these leaders who will ensure social housing is the go-to brand for young people. And it is these leaders who who will ensure we maintain our social purpose and deliver the homes that young people need. Thank you.